Don't say you can't help it. If you think you can't, the chances are that you can't. If you think you can, and act in accordance with this thought, then not only are the chances that you can, but if you act fully in accordance with it, that you can and that you will is an absolute certainty. It was Virgil who, in describing the crew, which in his mind would win the race, said of them they can because they think they can. In other words, this very attitude of mind on their part will infuse a spiritual power into their bodies that will give them the strength and endurance which will enable them to win. Then take the thought that you can. Take it merely as a seed thought, if need be, plant it in your consciousness, tend it, cultivate it, and it will gradually reach out and gather strength from all quarters. It will focus and make positive and active the spiritual force within you that is now scattered and of little avail. It will draw to itself force from without. It will draw to your aid the influence of other minds of its own nature, minds that are fearless, strong, and courageous. You will thus draw to yourself and connect yourself with this order of thought. If earnest and faithful, the time will soon come when all fear will lose its hold, and instead of being an embodiment of weakness and a creature of circumstances, you will find yourself a tower of strength and a master of circumstances. We need more faith in everyday life, faith in the power that works for good, faith in the infinite God, and hence faith in ourselves created in His image. And however things at times may seem to go, however dark at times appearances may be, the knowledge of the fact that the Supreme Power has us in its charge as it has the suns and endless systems of worlds in space, will give us the supreme faith that all is well with us, the same as all is well with the world. Thou wilt keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on thee. There is nothing firmer and safer and surer than deity. Then, as we recognize the fact that we have it in our own hands to open ourselves ever more fully to this infinite power, and call upon it to manifest itself in and through us, we will find in ourselves an ever-increasing sense of power. For in this way we are working in conjunction with it, and it in turn is working in conjunction with us. We are then led into the full realization of the fact that all things work together for good to those that love the good. Then the fears and forebodings that have dominated us in the past will be transmuted into faith, and faith when rightly understood and rightly used is a force before which nothing can stand. Materialism leads naturally to pessimism. In addition, how could it do otherwise? A knowledge of the spiritual power working in and through us as well as in and through all things, a power that works for righteousness, leads to optimism. Pessimism leads to weakness. Optimism leads to power. The one who is centered in deity is the one who not only outrides every storm, but who through the faith, and so, the conscious power that is in him, faces storm with the same calmness and serenity that he faces fair weather, for he knows well beforehand what the outcome will be. He knows that underneath are the everlasting arms. He it is who realizes the truth of the injunction, "Rest in the Lord, wait patiently for him and he shall give thee thy heart's desire." All shall be given, simply given, to him who is ready to accept it. Can anything be clearer than this? In the degree, then, that we work in conjunction with the Supreme Power, do we need the less to concern ourselves about results. To live in the full realization of this fact and all that attends it brings peace, a full, rich, abiding peace, a peace that makes the present complete, and that, going on before, brings back the assurance that as our days, so shall our strength be. The one, who is thus centered, even in the face of all the unrest and the turmoil about us, can realize and say *. I stay my haste, I make delays, for what avails this eager pace? I stand amid eternal ways, and what is mine shall know my face. Asleep, awake, by night or day, the friends I seek are seeking me, no wind can drive my bark astray, nor change the tide of destiny. The waters know their own, and draw the brooks that spring in yonder height. So flows the good with equal law unto the soul of pure delight. The realization of perfect peace. This is the spirit of infinite peace, and the moment we come into harmony with it there comes to us an inflowing tide of peace, for peace is harmony. A deep interior meaning underlies the great truth: to be spiritually minded is life and peace. To recognize the fact that we are spirit, and to live in this thought, is to be spiritually minded, and so to be in harmony and peace. Oh, the thousands of men and women all about us weary with care, troubled and ill at ease, running hither and thither to find peace, weary in body, soul, and mind. Going to other countries, traveling the world over, coming back, and still not finding it? Of course, they have not found it and they never will find it in this way, because they are looking for it where it is not. They are looking for it without when they should look within. Peace is to be found only within, and unless one find it there he will never find it at all. Peace lies not in the external world. It lies within one's own soul. We may travel over many different avenues in pursuit of it, we may seek it through the channels of the bodily appetites and passions, we may seek it through all the channels of the external, we may chase for it hither and thither, but it will always be just beyond our grasp, because we are searching for it where it is not. In the degree, however, that we order the bodily appetites and passions in accordance with the promptings of the soul within, will the higher forms of happiness and peace enter our lives. But in the degree that we fail in doing this, will disease, suffering, and discontent enter in. To be at one with God is to be at peace. The child's simplicity is the greatest agency in bringing this full and complete realization. The child simplicity that recognizes its true relations with the Father's life. There are people I know who have come into such a conscious realization of their oneness with this infinite life, this spirit of infinite peace, that their lives are fairly bubbling over with joy. I have particularly in mind at this moment a comparatively young man who was an invalid for several years, his health completely broken with nervous exhaustion, who thought there was nothing in life worth living for, to whom everything and everybody presented a gloomy aspect, and he in turn presented a gloomy aspect to all with whom he came in contact. Not long ago he came into such a vital realization of his oneness with this infinite power, he opened himself so completely to its divine inflow, that today he is in perfect health, and frequently as I meet him now he cannot resist the impulse to cry out, "Oh, it is a joy to be alive." A police officer, many times when off duty and on his way home in the evening, there comes to him such a vivid and vital realization of his oneness with this infinite power, and this spirit of infinite peace so takes hold of and so fills him, that it seems as if his feet could scarcely keep to the pavement, so buoyant and so exhilarated does he become by reason of this inflowing tide. He who comes into this higher realization never has any fear, for he has always with him a sense of protection, and the very realization of this makes his protection complete. Of him it is true: no weapon that is formed against thee shall prosper, there shall no ill come nigh thy dwelling, thou shalt be in league with the stones of the field, and the beasts of the field shall be at peace with thee. These are the men and the women who seem to live charmed lives. The moment we fear anything, we open the door for the entrance of the actualization of the very thing we fear. An animal will never harm a person who is absolutely fearless in regard to it. The instant he fears, he opens himself to danger. And some animals, the dog for example, can instantly detect the element of fear, and this gives them the courage to do harm. In the degree that we come into a full realization of our oneness with this infinite power, do we become calm and quiet, undisturbed by the little occurrences that before so vex and annoy us. We are no longer disappointed in people, for we always read them aright.